Delicatessen opens with establishing shots of a tall building fronted by a butcher shop. We see Clapette, the butcher, sharpening his knives while a tenant is dressing himself with garbage. The tenant hides in a garbage can as the garbage truck pulls up. As the garbage men collect the other trash containers, the butcher keeps the one bag that the tenant is hiding in. The butcher drags the container back into the kitchen, opens the lid, and drives a knife down at the tenant. This is our introduction to the post-apocalyptic world of France in Delicatessen. The butcher has put out an ad in a newspaper, requiring someone to work on the upkeep of the building. But this is an obvious ploy to bring in future victims that are killed and later sold as food to the other tenants in the building. As hinted at by a discussion between the butcher and his daughter, this scheme has been going on for a long period of time. A former circus clown, Louison, arrives in response to the ad. He may be on the thin side and lack the skills for the odd jobs around the building, but Clapette keeps him on anyway. Things start out fine, but matters get complicated when Clapette's daughter, Julie, begins to fall in love with Louison. Meanwhile, the tenants quickly go through the meat of the last handyman and are demanding Clapette quickly kill off Louison. Out of desperation, Julie calls upon the underground minions known as the Troglodytes. Despite the bleak atmosphere, Delicatessen is a genre film with a lot of heart. The film can be described as a post-apocalyptic, dark romantic comedy involving cannibalism. There are a few sequences that are rhythmic. There's the tenant montage. There's also the short scene of Louison bouncing out of bed to find a specific spring. The cello musical saw duet might be one of the most romantic scenes in the genre of science fiction. To the credit of Jeunet and Caro, they keep the focus on the characters and not on the details of the end of the world. We never know what caused the apocalypse. Was it nuclear? Was it pollution that killed the crops? Why are the crops the currency? These are details other movies may fixate on, but Jeunet and Caro respect the audience enough not to have every element of the world addressed. For all we know, there are no crops because of Brando.
But Brando's got what plants crave. It's got electrolytes.
So wait a minute. What you're saying is that you want us to put water on the crops.
Yes.
Water. Like out the toilet?
One subplot that will raise eyebrows is the apparent schizophrenic Aurora. Her scenes of attempting suicide will strike many as being in bad taste and making light of mental illness. But given how this setup is paid off, I feel these sequences add to the film's dark humor. Another element that I had to think about was the pair of toy makers. There are maybe only two children that we see in the building, but these two are making toys in a large quantity. I figure that this was their routine. This was the only thing they knew. They aren't killers or thieves or scavengers. They're just humble toy makers trying to get by. The frogman in the basement, played by Howard Vernon, warrants some mention as well. He's an underdweller that has managed to not succumb to cannibalism. He's indulging in raw escargot and has an army of frogs. It's amusing to consider that snails are a delicacy of France and he's the only one not afraid to pursue that means of survival. The characters are a joy to watch, not only with their eccentricities, but for the emotion they can express with their faces. Louison, Clapette, and Julie are able to emote to a degree that I could probably watch this movie with the sound off and no subtitles and still understand what is happening. The film lends itself to being treated as a silent picture made decades after the format was considered obsolete. Junot and Koto are clearly students of film. The set design echoes the German expressionism of the silent era, a la Dr. Caligari. The dinner scene between Julie and Louison has its Chaplin-esque antics. The climactic scene of using water to escape danger seems straight out of The Testament of Dr. Mabuse. The music by Carlos de Alessio has a lightheartedness to it. The simple duet of the cello and musical saw is inspiring. The Tika Tika dance uses the main theme in a very quirky fashion. Time I thought it was a rearrangement of the piece Somewhere My Love. Turns out the main theme by De Alessio was an original piece that shares coincidental cues. Here's a comparison of the two. I'll start with the theme for Delicatessen and fade into Somewhere My Love. Pignon plays Louison and would become a regular for Junot, appearing in subsequent productions, as you'll see with the later reviews in this episode. Pignon has a charm and comedic timing that is similar to that of Chaplin and Keaton. There were some facial expressions that made me think of him as the French Robin Williams. Jean-Claude Dreyfus as Clapet has a comedic menace to him. He revels when it comes to the murder, but he has his tender moments as well. His scene with Julie over the fate of Louison shows Dreyfus as Clapet being confident in what he feels he's doing is right, letting his bloodlust convince him to be correct. Marie-Laure Donac as Julie may be the real hero of the film. In this world of goofy caricatures, she's the one who sees the gravity of the situation. Louison is actually the one in distress, and it's Julie, as well as Karen Viard's Mademoiselle Blousset, that get Louison out of danger. Sylvie Laguna steals the show as Aurora. I've already addressed the suicide subplot, but Laguna sells the humor of the sequence. In supporting roles, there's Rufus and Jacques Mathau as the toy makers. Tiki Holdago is the patriarch of a starving family. Even co-director Mark Caro cameos as one of the troglodytes. Delicatessen is a rich mix of humor, heart, and horror. The characters are just a pleasure to watch. The world leaves a lot to the imagination in a good way. I love the music and the set design. It should come to no surprise that this is one of my all-time top 10 films. This is available on a few streaming services, but I would recommend Tubi TV because it's free to watch, so why not?